Okay, now today's session is a daemon thread, very interesting topic in multi-threading. So what is a daemon thread? You heard there are two types of threads, a daemon threads and non-daemon threads. What is the meaning of non-daemon threads? Now you are creating, up to now you created so many threads like T1, you created thread demo T1 equal to new thread demo, like that. Some threads you created, T1 thread, T2 thread, you created these type of threads up to now. And by default, JVM also creates some threads. JVM also creates some threads. What are the threads? Now, main thread. Main thread is created by the JVM only. Now, what the main thread created by JVM is the comes under daemon thread or non-daemon thread? Well, first of all, what is the meaning of a daemon thread? A daemon thread is nothing but the thread which runs on a background. The thread which runs on a background and supports for non-daemon threads. Those type of threads are called as an a daemon threads. Okay, what is the meaning of a daemon? For what is thread? A flow of execution. So we've written one logic in run method. Now this logic is executed by the thread. My main job, where I can put my main job? In run method only. Now sometimes what happens, some other thread need to help this thread, other thread need to help this thread, but that is the helper thread, not the main thread. This is the main thread. So that helper thread will, what the helper thread will do? It will help the main thread. It will help the main thread. Suppose the T1 is the main thread, means T1 thread I created and it is executing run method. Meanwhile T1 needs some support, it will get the information from some other HTML or some other files. It needs some info. It is not a mandatory one, but it will helpful like that. So that's type of scenarios I will create one more thread, but this thread is not important, but a little bit important, and that will support the main thread. This job is not main, this is the job is main job, but this thread will support the main thread. So this type of threads are called daemon threads. So the daemon threads will support the non-daemon threads. Daemon threads will support the non-daemon threads. How can you say this thread is daemon? How can you say this thread is non-daemon? Simple. There is a method T1 dot set. What is the daemon? We are selling about daemon. Set daemon. True. By default, it is not nothing. Whatever the parent thread has, the child thread inherit that future. If you want to change that future, you need to set to daemon is true. Set to daemon is true. Okay. For example, JVM creates one thread. That thread name is main. What is the daemon? Is the daemon is false. How can you know how to print is the daemon or not? One more method is there. Is daemon will return true or false. If it is a daemon thread, returns true. If it is a non-daemon thread, it will return false. By default, main method, what it will return? False. From that main method, you can create any number of threads. T1 thread you created, T2 you created. So by what is the, you are not setting any value to set to daemon, you are not using them. What is the, is the T1 thread is daemon or not daemon? Your parent thread value, it will inherited. Means if parent thread is non-daemon, so it is also non-daemon. Suppose T1 T3 is created by T1. T3 is created by T1. Now T3 value also false. Non-daemon thread only. For suppose you created a T1 thread. What is the parent thread? Which thread created T1? Main thread created T1 thread. Now T1 dot set to daemon. If you write like that, now this T1 thread is a daemon thread. Now the child thread, by default child thread also means that T1 creates some other thread. That thread T3 is also a daemon thread. So whatever the parent thread, if parent thread is daemon, then child thread also becomes daemon by default. Remember, by default only. If you want, you can change. If parent thread is non-daemon, then child thread by default non-daemon. If you want to change the daemon nature, before the thread starting, you need to change. Set to daemon is true false. If you put true, it is a daemon thread. If you put false, non-daemon thread. But after starting the thread, you don't change the daemon nature. If you change, it will throw thread illegal state exception, it will throw. So if before thread starting only, you can change the daemon nature of the thread. After once thread is started, you can't change. If you try to change the daemon nature after T1 dot start, if you call T1 dot set daemon true like that, it will throw an exception. Before start only you need to set is that daemon thread or non-daemon thread. Before thread start, once the thread started, you can't change. If you try to change, it will throw an exception. Now it is the one. Now one more thing, the daemon, the JVM creates main thread. It is a non-daemon thread and it will starts the execution in main method. Of course, some static blocks it will execute if they are in your class. Otherwise, it will start execution from main method. So, your main thread is created by the JVM and its execution starts from main method. And the JVM also creates some daemon threads. Main thread is a non-daemon thread. Non-daemon thread. Daemon means very low priority thread. Helper threads, by simple meaning, daemon thread is a not a main thread, it is a simply helper threads. The main job of daemon is it will not execute a main logic, it will execute some helper type of logics like a servant. A daemon thread is like a servant to the main threads. Now by default the JVM creates one thread. What is the thread name? Main thread. It is a non-daemon thread. Along with main, it creates some other threads. What are the threads? Garbage collector, signal dispatcher. Garbage collector, signal dispatcher. Some attach listener. Attach listener, reference handler, destroy JVM. Some daemon threads it created along with non-daemon thread main. So main is a non-daemon thread, reference handler, destroy JVM, garbage collector, signal dispatcher. These some daemon threads are also there. Some daemon threads, 5 or 6, some more daemon threads it will create, and one non-daemon thread. What is that non-daemon thread? Main thread. That's why if you create T1 thread, T2 thread, by default what is that, those threads daemon or non-daemon? It's non-daemon. Why? Because main thread only it will create. So main thread will inherit the, so those properties will inherit it to the T1 and T2 thread. That's why those are also non-daemon threads. Now if you can ask, sir, if JVM will create a main thread, it is a non-daemon thread, means it will execute main method logic. But what about what about daemon threads like garbage collector, signal dispatcher, request handler, destroy JVM, finalizer? These are daemon threads created by JVM and run in background. You can't see where these threads are running, which method is these threads are executing, which method you don't know, because these threads are running on background, not front. main thread is running on front, in front, the main method. You can see, you can debug the main method, but main thread execution you can debug, but those threads you can't debug because those methods will execute some internal methods like some Java given some methods and with low priority. For example, garbage collector thread will, what it will do, suppose main thread is executing, so main thread creates so many number of objects like lakh, 1 lakh of objects. It is still creating and going like that, main thread. But what happens, maybe sometimes the memory will be full. So on that time, what JVM will do, it will call garbage collector thread. So garbage collector thread will clean up the only unused objects, not used objects. Suppose some objects are not using in Java, those are unused objects. It will destroy those objects and clean the memory. So then your main thread will start execution again, means it will continue its execution with memory, with high memory. So the garbage collector is the daemon thread and main thread is the non-daemon thread. So garbage collector is supporting the main thread or not? Yes, it's supporting. How it is supporting? By cleaning the objects, by removing the objects from heap size, unused objects it is removing. Means some daemon threads will support the non-daemon threads. So your main thread, how much time main thread will execute? Up to completion of your main method. If main method completes, your main thread also completes. Now what about daemon threads? How much time these will complete? Daemon thread, there is no time, because if all main threads, means all non-daemon threads are completed, then automatically the process will be terminated. Because if you want, you can also create non-daemon threads, daemon thread also. For example, here if you see now I created one thread and this thread will execute run method. In this while loop will execute infinity number of times. Now I will get the output like, I am a daemon thread, false. I am a daemon thread, so it is a non-daemon thread. Like it will execute, so this thread is executing infinity number of times because in while of true, so it will execute like this. In middle, main thread, if you see, by default, what is the main thread? Thread dot current thread means main thread. Main thread is daemon? No, false. Means main thread is not daemon thread. And after 3 seconds, it printed main thread. So main thread is completed. Now which thread is executing? My T1 thread is executing. What is my T1 thread? Daemon, non-daemon? It's a non-daemon thread. That's why it is executing. So if you see, suppose if my T1 thread becomes daemon thread, and if I run, yeah, my main thread is not a daemon. I am daemon thread, main thread. After main thread, your terminal is stopped. Why? Because once main thread completed, there is no non-daemon thread presented. All threads are completed, but one thread is there, T1 thread. T1 thread need to execute infinity number of times, but T1 thread is a daemon thread. Daemon thread will be terminated automatically when your non-daemon, all non-daemon threads are completed in your application, in your program. If all non-daemon threads are completed, then automatically daemon threads will be completed, means stop its execution. If still there is a code to execute, but it will not execute because daemon threads are helper threads for main threads. If main thread completes, then daemon threads, which thread it will help? Which thread? It will help to which thread? So if main thread completes, if that, it will automatically terminate its execution. If still code is available, but it will terminate its execution. So that is the difference between daemon and non-daemon thread. Okay. Now one more thing. If you after start if I set, after start if I set set to daemon true, it will throw an exception, illegal thread state exception. So don't set daemon nature after thread start. Can you change the main thread to daemon nature? Because the main method, main thread created by whom? JVM. Now I want to change my main thread as a daemon. By default it's a non-daemon thread. I want to change a daemon, my main thread. Is that possible? No, because the main thread created by the JVM and already its execution is started. Once execution is started, you can't change the nature of daemon. Before execution only you can change. So main thread already started the execution, so you can't change the daemon nature for main thread. If you try to change the daemon nature of a main thread, it will throw an exception called illegal thread illegal state exception. Illegal thread state exception. Okay. So life of a daemon thread is whenever your not daemon threads are executed, it will execute. If it is completed, it will also terminate its process. So next topic is green thread. Sir, in Java there are two types of models, two types of threads. One is green thread, one is native OS thread. What is the meaning of a green thread? Nothing is there. Green thread is nothing but the thread. If you create a thread, the execution of the thread, all those things, who will take care? The execution, the time allocation, who will take care? Some thread scheduler. If the thread scheduler takes the help of only JVM and it is not taking the help of operating system, then those threads are called green threads. Means if thread is in a execution flow, so a thread needed to, if thread wants to execute, it needed help of two softwares. One is your JVM support is needed, and one is your operating system. But some threads, if JVM supports and operating system both software supports the thread execution, if thread is executing, it needed support of JVM and operating system both support, if thread has, then those threads are called native operating system threads, native OS model, the thread following native model, native OS, or non-green threads. If thread only taking the support of JVM, not taking operating system, those threads are called green threads. Those threads are deprecated and we can't use those threads. But some operating systems supports green threads, like Sun, Polaris, some operating systems. So Sun, Solaris provides the supporting for green thread, but Windows, Mac, Linux, Ubuntu, these type of operating systems won't provide the support for green threads. Because if you run any thread, if you create a thread in JVM, automatically OS will help that thread scheduler. If OS will not support the green threads, it will not support the threads, those threads are called green threads. If threads are supported by the JVM and operating system, those threads are called native OS threads. So definitely thread need a help of JVM. If only JVM it is taking, it is called green thread. Along with JVM, if it is take help of OS, operating system help also, it is called native OS model. So these are the threads, native OS model threads and green thread. I hope you understand what is the daemon thread, what is the non-daemon thread, what are the default Java given default daemon threads, how to create our own custom daemon threads. Some concepts we are discussed in this class, in this session. So in next session we will going to discuss about thread dump stack. What is a thread dump stack? What is the guardian blocks? Some concepts we need to discuss in next sessions. Okay. Thank you.